In previous tutorial, we discussed basic concept of the SQL loaders and the different files that are available in the SQL loaders. Now, today we discuss how we can perform SQL loadings or how we can use the SQL loader to load the data from the different data files to the Oracle database tables. So for that one, we see that we are having the different types of files are available in SQL loaders. First one, we have to prepare the data file. So whenever we are having the data files are there, so we may have the data files in the different formats, that is .csv file formats, that is .dat file format or .txt file format. So first of all, very first steps, we have to create the or we have to prepare the data files. Let we want to prepare the new data file in CSV file format. You can prepare it in txt, dat or .csv file format. So let me create it over here, notepad. Okay, file, let we are having data is related to the employee id 1, name is here Rafi, and then we are having the salary of that one is here 50,000, id 2 Arof. And then we are having here, we are having 45,000. Then we are having 3, name is here Ali. The salary of this one, we are having the 25,000. And we are having ID 4. Then we are having, the name is here Asad. And salary of that one, we set as 27,000. So we are having here four different records are there related to employees. So here we are having the delimiter separators formats available over here. We are not using here the fixed partition files format. We are using the delimiter separators. We can use it over here instead of comma. We can use it over here. This one symbol. We can use the hash symbols. We can use any other symbol over here. So whenever we are having file is available, we have to save it. File save as. I want to create it, save it over here in the D drive. In D drive I want to create the new folders. So new folders, folder name is here emp, and emp folders I want to create the files with the file format CSV. So let me say that emp_data.csv. This one file format is comma separated value, and that is a data files. Save. So in data files we are having the four different records are available, having the three attributes, employee ID, employee name and salary of that one. Let me close this one and check that one folder over here in D drive. We are having emp folder, and emp folder we are having the emp data is available, comma separated value that will be displayed over here in the Excel sheet. Okay, open this one. Okay, over here we are having that is available in the Excel sheet. We close this one. Now first steps, that's done, prepare the data files. Now we have to go for the second steps, and second step is we have to prepare the control files. And control file, that is you that provide the interface between the data files and the tables. And for that one, we are having the extension .ctl. So here we have to use it over here. So for that one, we have in control file, we have the three main type of extension are available. So let me create the control file. That is used to load the data. For that one we have to use the load data, and over here we are having the three main options are there: insert, truncate and append. Insert, whenever our table is empty, we don't have any data in a table, for that one we have to select the option insert. If we have an insert into table and name of table, let we are having table is here, and I didn't create yet table, so I have to create this one tables. insert into table name of tables. Okay, now we can use over here append or truncate. Insert, whenever table is empty, then we have to use the insert. If we see that we are having the data already and we want to append new data with the existing data, so for that one, attach new data with the existing data, then we have to select the option of append. Otherwise, we have to select if we want to data is available and we want to remove that one data and store the new data from the data file. So for that one, we have to use the concept of truncate. So here we can use it over here, insert, append, or truncate option. So for that one, control files, we are having three main options are available. Okay, now let me first complete this one. Insert load data, insert into table name of tables, and then we are having the field, and the fields are terminated by these fields are terminated by, we see that these fields are terminated by comma. And if we want to use it, if somewhere we are having the comments, otherwise we are having the hash symbols or any others, so for that one slash any others, so for that one we have to use it over here optionally in close, optionally enclose, optionally enclose by. So we see that here we can use it over here optionally enclose by this one, and then we see that we are having the different columns names are here. So column names are here MID, we are having next one column is emp name, and we are in next one column header column is here emp, let me see that salary. Two main columns data is available, emp ID names and salary values are available over here in the data file. So same, we have to store it over here. So for that one, we have to save this one file, file save as, and that one we see that this one file name is m_control.ctl. Save it over there in the same folder where we are having the data, previous data is available over there. Save it, done, close it. Now here we are having the two main files, one is control file, second one is the data file. Now let me create the tables in SQL plus connect with hr at pdborcl pluggable database hr. Okay, create SQL. Now I want to create table. Table name of table is here m, and here we are having the folder columns that have emp id. Data type of this one is here number, then we are having the emp names. Data type of this one is voucher 2, size of this one is 25 characters, and then we are having the emp salary, and that one is also a number. And now we are having this one, table is created. Now when table is created, let me check select static from emp tables, we don't have any record, no row selected over here. Now here we are having the data available in the data files using the control files. We have to load the data from data files into the SQL tables using the SQL loaders. So how, for that one we have to use it over here, command prompt, open the command prompt screens. Okay, over here SQL loaders, then we have to use the usernames and password. Username is here hr, password is here hr at pdborcl, right? Now after that one, don't press enters, use it over here. The data means that is used to store the data files. Assign the path of the data files. That for the path of the data files that is available in the D drive, and emp_data/emp_data. That is our data file dot csv, right? After that one, we are having another file is available. Inside one file, we are having control. And for the control files, we see that path, same path, d drive m, and folder name is here, file name is there, m underscore controls dot ctl. M underscores control dot ctl, two files. Now the next one we have to use it over here, log files. Log is equal to, so in the same files we want to store all the information over here, m, and then I say that we m underscore log dot txt. After that one, we are having the concept of the bad file, the record data rejected, that will be stored in the bad files. So for the bad, that is equal to, let me say d underscore m d, and then we are having m, and then we say that m underscore bad, what are the different record data rejected, that will move to the bad file dot bad. And after that one, we are having the discard, and that what we have, the record that are not due to some business logic, those record will reject, that will move to the discard. So for that one, we see that dm, and then we see that m underscore discard. You can use any names of this one, these file, discard file, log file, of your own choice. Okay, that's done. And now we have to press the enter it over here. Let me check. So here field is terminated by, so I have the problems with my control files, and that problem is terminated. Let me open the control files. So over here, this one spellings are wrong, file save. So now again, let me re-execute this one. Okay, now it see that four rows successfully loaded over there. Commit permitted, read logical, record count 3, and then we are having the 4. So we are having the log file is created over here. More information we can check it over here, m blogs. So let me check the log files, m blogs. So here's all the information that are available. It says that 4 records are inserted over here, successfully inserted, and space allocated by the binary array, that is a JSON amount, and all other informations are available. Okay, let me check the SQL plus again. Here select static from imp, and now we have the 4 different records that are available over here that were previously available in our data file. Now those records are moved from the data file to the SQL table using the control files. Thanks for watching the video.